Coming up on Sports Weekly, San Gorgonio High School hosted a college showcase for players from San G, Cajon, Carter, and Redlands East Valley. Plus, we'll announce the winners of the 2016 Ken Hubs Award. That's coming up on Sports Weekly. 50 great athletes who excelled on the field, in the classroom, and in the community were honored at the 52nd annual Ken Hubs Awards, but only one boy and one girl could walk away with the big prize. Cajon High School basketball star Kayla Washington and San Bernardino High School football standout Alexander Mattison are your 2016 Ken Hubs Award winners. 25 schools and 50 student athletes were represented at the 52nd annual Hubs Award banquet, with Washington and Mattison winning the ultimate prize. Washington will play basketball in college at Washington State University, while Mattison is headed to Boise State to play football. An incredible honor for Mattison and Washington, especially considering the man and the athlete the award is named after, Ken Hubs.
I'm so honored, and it's just a really big deal, and I'm so blessed for this opportunity and all my talents. So this is like crazy. I would never dream of my high school career ending this way, but I'm truly honored, and this is great, so I'm really happy. I kind of blinked out, like my brother was like, go Kayla, go, and I was like, oh my goodness, I wasn't even expecting it. Like, it's just, it was amazing, and this whole experience was so nice, and it's a really big deal, so I'm really happy. I mean, the history was crazy behind this award and everything he did as a young athlete, and he inspired so many people. So to receive this award, it was just a really big deal, and I'm glad that they even considered me for it, and then to win is just even.
As soon as I started hearing things that were hinting at that it was me, I immediately felt the adrenaline start pumping, my heart started pumping, my face was getting hot. It was such an honor, especially for him to compare me to his older brother or his younger brother. That was such an honor, and I just felt speechless. That's all I can really put on it, and excitement, and everything just felt surreal at the moment. It makes it a lot more special, considering that he was just a great man, and life is outstanding, especially for me to be compared to that. I will continue, and I strive to be that excellent person in life, not only on the field, but off the field. And so it's an honor to be compared to such a great man, and I will continue to be following his footsteps and try to be as impactful as I can to everyone.
High school football players from four different local schools had the chance to play in front of 40-plus college football coaches at San Gorgonio High School.
Hey, keep getting work like this. Hey, show we can play. Show who we are. Let's go. Hey, GL3. 1, 2, 3.
The Spartans hosted its college showcase, giving players from San G, Cajon, Carter, and Redlands East Valley an amazing opportunity to get exposure from many of the top college programs on the West Coast, including UCLA, Stanford, Utah, and many others from the Pac-12. Dozens of college coaches watched as the players ran through drills, went one-on-one, and played 7-on-7. It was a great chance to catch a coach's eye and hopefully earn a college scholarship to play football. No doubt there's plenty of talent on the field, as the players were looking to make a good impression.
The one thing that, you know, they get, you, when you get in this situation with all the different schools, you know, the energy, they can get a little overexcited right now and do some things that they shouldn't do. So we're always trying to keep the cool heads going with these kids and keeping them prepared.
Yeah, it's a different thing. We, you know, we've never done it. It's something we've been kind of talking about, me and Coach Gehringer over there at San G. And so, you know, we talked about it. He kind of put some stuff together, and it ends up being a really good event for our kids and some good exposure for them.
There's going to be a lot of coaching, but you just need to impress them, come out here, work hard, and show them what we got.
How do you think you're doing so far?
I think I'm doing all right. I hope I impressed them.
You know, it just coming out here was great. Seeing the college coaches come out, it kind of made me nervous a little bit, but, you know, I got used to it after a while, and I think I showed out too. My footwork was better than last year. You know, last year I was kind of stepping out of the bucket a lot, and I kind of fixed that. I've been training hard this offseason, just getting back into things.
We had probably between 30 to 40 schools, and it was fantastic. Got to see Coach Erickson, who's a legend, you know, from the U, and he's at Utah. We had Pac-12 representatives, we had UCLA, we had Colorado State. We just had a ton of schools. We were real excited about this opportunity, and we worked real hard at trying to put a showcase together, and we think we did a good job.
Well, the message was to have fun tonight. You know, if kids came out here and thought about who was here and everything else, it was about having fun. But it is also, you know, being able, hey, you got to put something out there, because you can't sell yourself if you don't have any good film. And then when guys are here, you got to produce. So that's kind of what we talked about a little bit. We put a lot of preparation in, and our kids did an outstanding job.
Still to come on Sports Weekly, the Citrus Belt League baseball title came down to the final day of the regular season. We've got the dramatic highlights coming up next on Sports Weekly on IEMG. Well, that'll do it for this episode of Sports Weekly. You can watch all the segments from this show and past shows on the IEMG YouTube channel. And please hit that subscribe button when you're visiting us on YouTube. I'm Pep Fernandez, and we'll see you next time on Sports Weekly on IEMG.